we're really chuffed today to bring you a tutorial which is really practical advice on showreel content, but also a really technical tutorial on how to cut things together. So that's going to be led by Warren Blackmore, who I'll introduce you to in a second. And just to tell you who I am, I work with Backstage and I have done for the last 3 years in the UK. And I'm also a casting director and I've worked in casting for the last 10 years. So I'm going to give a bit of information to you guys about the content in your showreel, and then I'll pass you straight on over to Warren, who is going to be teaching you how to actually cut everything together. I'll introduce you to Warren now. Who's also going to show you his production showreel. And then I will come back and speak to you in a minute.
Cool. Hello. Thank you, Hannah. Let me just change this. So, yeah, thanks for everybody joining. Basically, my name is Warren. I run a production company called Lab Class. We're based in the UK. We work with brands like Amazon, Beats. We work with fashion retailers, Emeco, and lots more. We make TV commercials. We make brand films, fashion films, animation, documentaries. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to share my screen now. And I'm going to show you our production showreel, just to give you an idea of the kind of stuff that we do. Okay, so that is our real stuff there. Back to you, Hannah.
Okay, so I'm just going to talk everyone through what we're going to be doing today. If you have any questions, drop me a message in the chat, and I'll pick them up at the end with Warren, and I'll ask your questions for you. If there's anything that you have in particular with the technical side or the content side, either side is fine. Just ask the question and I'll pick it up later for you. If there's anything you're not quite understanding or you want us to go back, just let me know, and within reason I can interject and ask Warren to repeat things if we need to. So questions, you go there. If you want to tag us at all, we're on Backstage Cast on Instagram and at Backstage on Twitter. Warren is also at Lab Class Studio on Twitter and at Lab Class Creative on Instagram. And he is at Warren_Blackmore on Instagram as well. We are recording this, as I mentioned earlier. So before we put this out, as part of our article, which is around... all of the slate and what is happening this week. We did put next to Warren's session that you should try and download the 7-day trial for Premiere Pro, Adobe Premiere Pro. If you haven't done that, that's absolutely fine. To be honest with you, it's gonna be quite hard for you to work along whilst we're doing this. You sort of do, unless you've got a double screen situation, you do need to be watching everything. So what I recommend is taking notes on everything that Warren approaches today. We're recording this, so we're going to hopefully get this up like as soon as possible, so that if you are editing at the moment, then you can come back and watch again. Also, if you've got any questions, guys, I work with Backstage. I would love to see your show reels anyway. So at the end, you are so welcome. I would love to see actually your show reels. And I'm on hannah.williams@backstage.com. So send them over and I'll give you some feedback. And if there's any particular questions you're looking at with tech, then I can also ask Warren for you. So I'm just going to run through what we're going to be doing. So we're going to be learning today how to set things up and use the interface on Premiere Pro. Obviously, there's so much you can do with this software, but what we're going to just show you today is just for the purposes of cutting your own showreel. Sorry, let me just admit those people. We're going to show you how to import your files, so when you're cutting your showreel together, you're going to have all these files from different places, how you cut out the clips that you want to show you your performance, and how you add them into a showreel and cut it all together. We're also going to be showing you how to make a slate at the beginning and the end if that's something you wanted, and also credit titles. So at the beginning of your clips for your credits as they go along, we're going to show you how to add those credits in. And then we'll show you the showreel overall and the one that we've been working on today. We've got footage today from a really amazing actress called Kristen McElwam. I will give you her information at the end. She's really incredible and we're so thankful for her sending us her footage for this today. We think what we've made with it is really exciting. So just coming back to why we're doing all of this at Backstage. Obviously, we want to keep people inspired and motivated. And part of that is, you know, during this downtime is a really good opportunity for you guys to start refining your package. So really thinking about what's on your CV, having a look at your showreel. Can it be better? Is there things you want to add into there? Obviously, at the moment, we've got lots of time to research into agents that we might be approaching for representation. So we thought this was a good idea to help you complete the package with showreel. It's really important you keep your showreel up to date as much as you possibly can. Make sure that all the content is really representative of you and shows a really good range as well. The thing that I would say with to students and people just entering into the industry is, or anyone, to be honest with you, if you're not sure on a bit of content and you're just putting it in there to bulk out the reel, just take it out. If it doesn't show you in your best light, then there's no point in keeping it in. I tell you for why. Because we don't have too much time as casting directors to watch 3 minutes all the way through, especially when we're looking for 8 roles on a commercial or whatever it is. A lot of the time, it is flicking through. So you want to make sure that every one of those flicks that I go through is strong and hopefully shows you in a little bit of a different light, so that if this first thing that you've put in the reel isn't quite right for what I am hoping for in the role, that when I flick to the next one, it might be getting a bit warmer to it, and we just want to see a bit of variation in there. But yes, I would definitely take out anything that you're not too sure on. If in doubt, take it out. Just make sure you keep it updated as much as you can. Lengthwise, I would try and keep it to 3 minutes. Anything past that is a little bit of overkill. And you wanna be showing your best work. And also, if you're in a scene with somebody and the scene, we're gonna go through this and show you how to do it in a technical sense. But if you're in a scene and you're not the main focus of that scene, we want to be able to see your performance and not the other person's performance. you can edit things in a clever way to make sure that you're the focus of what we're actually seeing. So I'll let Warren explain more of what I mean there and show you how you can do that. But like I said, take notes. We will be recording, and I'll come back at the end to pass on your questions to Warren so he can answer them all. And I'll hand you over. Thank you so much.
First of all, unmute my mic. So thank you, Hannah. Let's see if I can share the correct screen this time. Okay, share screen and this time one, share. Okay, so just gonna make sure that you guys can hear my computer audio as well. Okay, so as Hannah mentioned, we're gonna be using Premiere Pro. And basically this software is a super powerful piece of software. You guys can download a 7-day trial and you'll be able to have that program fully unlocked for 7 days, so you'll be able to edit your showreels. So this software is made by Adobe, and things like Mindhunter, Deadpool 1 and 2, Gone Girl were all edited in this software, so super powerful piece of software. But before we get into Premiere Pro, I just want to talk to you about managing your files. So it's super important to be organized with all your files. And this is a basic kind of file folder setup that I've got for this project. We've got assets, exports, and project files. So project files is where you will save your Premiere Pro project file. Exports is where you're going to export your showreel, and then assets, this is everything that makes up your showreel. So here I've got a headshot. We've got all the different files, all the different films and little clips. Here we've then got the credits. And yeah, that's basically, and then here we got some sound effects. So as a kind of an option, maybe some of you guys have been in music videos and you really liked your performance, but maybe the song doesn't quite work inside your showreel. So an idea would be to cut a small, you know, 2 or 3 clips of that performance and maybe add some ambient sounds, something similar to what's going on. If it's out in the street, you put some street sounds and that would help with your showreel. So what I'll do, we'll now open up Premiere Pro for the first time. So let's close that for the moment. Okay. Okay, and straight away, we're gonna click on new project. You go to the folders that you've created. So it is basically project files. So this is the folder that you wanna save your, create your project. So we choose that. I'm gonna call this show real demo. Okay, so the first thing you see is the interface, and we are going to be using a panel or a layout, and we're going to be using the editing layout, and basically this is your project folder. So this is where all your files need to come. So that's our first job, is to import all the files. So you would go right click and import. You then go to your folder that you created with all of your assets. So assets and footage. So this is all the footage, but what you can do is if you click the folder, you can import the folder and that will bring in the folder and that'll keep all those video files inside that folder because we may want to import something else and you just want to keep everything organized. So the next thing that you would do, you want to create what we call a sequence. So we would go file, new, sequence, and we are going to be making a 1080 HD video file. So this preset, digital SLR, 1080p at 25 frames a second is usually okay. And we can then choose the name of the sequence, and we're going to call this showreel demo, and then okay. So now this is your sequence. So this is where all of your clips are going to be. And then you've got up here, this is where you'll see your sequence being played. Now, if I double click on any of these video files, this will be opened up in a preview up here. So this is where you would scrub through and choose the clips that you want. But before we do that, at the start of any showreel, you would first have your slate. So we are going to import the headshot. So again, file, import, and we want to go back to the assets, and then inside headshot, we're going to import that folder to keep everything nice and tidy, import. So we got the headshot. So we're going to just drag that down onto the sequence timeline. Okay, so this image is too big. So what I would do next, next to this preview section, we've got effects control. And I will select the headshot. And then I have some options here about scaling and resizing and positioning. So first thing I need to do is scale the image down. Okay, something like that. And then I want to move that over to the right. So I basically use these tools here. And yeah, I'm happy with that. And then basically this is where you would put your name. And if you've got an agent, you put your agent, or you could, if you haven't got an agent, you could put your Backstage profile. So first of all, I'm just going to do the slate. So if we go back to the credits, so inside assets and credits, here we have the correct spelling. So this is how it sounds, basically. So Kristen McElwain. Anyway, so this is the correct spelling. So I'm gonna copy that, and I'm now gonna put some text in. So just here, you've got your text tool. So click that, and then click inside this area. And then on your keyboard, you would do Command V. So there's the text there. So the next tab at the top basically is graphics. So at the moment we're in editing mode, and now because I've added some graphics and some text, I wanna head over to here. So when you click that, it gives you some more options. And then in the essential graphics tab, when you click edit, here's the options for the text. So first of all, I don't really like that font, so I'm going to choose something else. So let's go for this one. And again, we want to change the position of this. So there's two ways of doing it. You can either press V, and that changes it back to your cursor, and you can literally just move that around and position it. You've also got these tools here, which is the align tool. So we want to, if we want that in the center, we click this, it'll just lock that, so that's centered. So it's probably a little bit too big, so we'll just bring the size down a touch, something like that, and let's get that centered, probably about there. Okay, and I would say the length of this would probably be about 3 seconds. So I'm just clicking away. Basically, this at the bottom of the time, this is so you can zoom in and out of your timeline. And then up here, this shows you your seconds. So you got 3 seconds there, and then basically click, drag, and you can select and change the length of those two just by clicking, holding the click, and dragging. So we're changing that and we're moving that down to 3 seconds. So we can play that. And that's 3 seconds long. But I think if we just extend it a little bit and maybe put a fade. So for that, now we're happy with the text, we're happy with the headshot. We are gonna probably go back to the editing tab, the editing layout, and at the top here where you've got your effects control, and down here you've got different kind of tabs, and we're going to go for effects here, and we've got video transitions, and we want dissolve and cross dissolve. Basically, we pop that on the end of the text, and pop that on the end of the headshot. And then just play that back. And I'm just thinking that the headshot could probably come over just a touch. So if you want to edit, you just click this. You've got your effects controls up here. And we're just going to move it over just a touch. Something like that. Okay, cool. So that's the first part. That's your slate. And then underneath the name, you would put, as I mentioned, maybe an agent or your backstage profile. Okay, so we're gonna go back to the project and we're gonna go back to the footage. And the first one that we're gonna be editing is a short film. Kristen played the lead in this film. So I'm gonna double click on this. And now I can, up here, scrub through the entire film very quickly, and I can go to any part of that film just by dragging across. But we're gonna just scrub through here, and we're just gonna have a little look. So, keyboard shortcuts. So I'll talk about keyboard shortcuts. So if you wanna just play it, you hit spacebar. And if you wanna stop it, you hit spacebar. So that's to start and stop. Then if you use the arrow keys, you can shuttle through the frames. So basically left and right, forward, back. And then if you want to scrub through a little bit faster, if you hold the shift key and arrow keys, it moves a bit faster through the frames. So this scene is what we'd like to include in the show reel. So what we'll do is we'll first find our in point. So the in point is basically the start of the clip that we want to use, and then we'll scrub through to the out point, which is at the end. So so this is basically what we would do. We would scrub through until we're happy.
Oh my God, you're going to love it.
I'm just using the arrow keys just to scrub through. Okay, so our endpoint is there. So I press I, and then I'm gonna play it.
Oh my God, you're gonna love it. Beach all day, karaoke all night. And I used to shave my legs, put a skirt on, and I would run rings around.
10 now.
Double figures.
Okay, so I want to use that part. So just before that music comes in. So again, using the arrow keys, just scrubbing back and forth. So, okay, so that is the last frame of that shot. And if I go forward one frame, that is the first frame of the next shot. So our out point needs to be on the last but one frame of the shot. So not the last one, so there. So then I press O for out. And then you can see down here that it's selected this part of the video that I want. So there's two ways to bring this into your timeline. You can either click the video anywhere and just hold and drag down like that. Or if you hit full stop or period, if you're in the US, that will do the same thing. So that will automatically drag down that clip into the timeline. So as you can see, it looks different in this window than it does this window. So I would say that this film is probably 4K. The resolution is 4K and our sequence is HD. And what we want to do here, because we are making our showreel that's going to be used online and shared, so we don't want it to be too big, that's going to eat up lots of bandwidth, so it's a good manageable size, but also good enough quality. But when you've got video files that are higher resolution than your sequence, all you do is you right click on your clip that you've brought into your sequence, and you're looking for the option which is set to frame size. So I click that and it basically brings it in to fit. So this is our clip, our first
clip. Oh my God, you're gonna love it. Beach all day, karaoke all night. And I used to shave my legs, put a skirt on, and I would run the winds around this time.
Okay, so again, as Hannah mentioned, we need to show the performance and we need to keep our viewer engaged, and we don't want them to get bored. And as much as, you know, everybody loves showing as much work as they can, we need to really kind of condense it. So what I would do then with this clip, so I'm gonna zoom in using these tools here. So I've got this full clip. And I'm just going to look again here. So I'm using spacebar to press play.
Oh my God, you're going to love it.
Spacebar to stop. What I would do, I think that
first
shot needs to be just a little bit longer. So I can just move this around, zoom in some more, and again, hover the mouse, and you're able to drag across.
Oh my God, you're going to love it. Beach all day.
Okay, move that back there.
Hey, karaoke all night. And I used to shave my legs, put a skirt on, and I would run the winds around this time.
Okay, so this shot, we can cut this shot. So again, using the arrow keys, we're going to scrub through until we're the end of that shot. So here's another shortcut. So if you press C, changes your cursor to a razor. So that's C for cut, and we're making our first cut. So the timeline here, and we've got snap on, and we're just going to cut there. So that's made a cut, and we're going to scrub forward. I would say we could lose this shot as well. So we'll just play that through, and let's scrub back. So our cut is on the first frame of that shot, and we're going to cut there. So now this is a cut, and we're going to delete this. So we want to press V, and that brings us back to our cursor, and we can select that, and you can just hit delete on the keyboard, and that's gone. Now there's two ways that you can work here. You can either click in this negative space and hit delete, and that will bring the clip.
Okay. 10 now.
Like that, or you can just drag it over. I think maybe, I'm just looking at that now.
Put a start on and I would run the rings around this, Kelly.
Okay, so I think we needed that shot before. So basically I'm just gonna bring this over. Let's have a look. Let's go there. So negative space, hit delete.
Put a start on and I would run the rings around this, Kelly.
10 now.
Double figures.
Okay, cool. So let's just have a look, look at the start of that.
Oh my God, you're gonna love it. Oh my God, you're gonna love it.
Beach all day, karaoke all night.
No, I used to shave my legs, put a start on and I would run rings around this too.
10 now.
Double figures.
Okay, cool. So, let's look at that last.
Oh my God, you're gonna...
So, yeah, I'm just using this to zoom in and have a little look at where that cut is. Okay, so we're gonna add some more from this film. So again, we can go back to our source file, basically. So we've got our sequence here. You've got the preview of the sequence here, and this is our source video file. So now, using this, I'm gonna pull back out, and we're just gonna scrub through to find our next scene. So. So I think we're going to take something from this part. Okay. Okay, so we're going to watch it from here.
Oh, you've seen a little...
So again, using the arrow keys, we're scrubbing through until we want our first frame. So there, and then we put in point. So I...
Have you seen a little girl about this big, brown hair?
Oi, she'll be around.
Summer? Summer!
Oi, talk to me. Please, come on. Ronnie! Ronnie, what's going on? Talk to me.
I'm not meant to be here.
What do you mean?
Skip out! Summer!
Look, I'll help you, all right? Ronnie, I'll help you. I'll help
Fuck
you.
Off, Daddy!
Okay, so then we're going to say out here, and then full stop or period for to bring this into the timeline. So just do that, or you can click the video and drag it in. So this is a good scene. It's a lot different from the first one, and there's lots going on, but it's too long and we've chopped that right down. Let's have another little look here. Again, we need to make this fit our sequence. So right click, set to frame size. Okay, let's just play this through.
A little girl about this big, brown hair.
Oh, she'll be around.
Summer? Summer!
Please, come on. Ronnie!
Okay, so...
Ronnie!
So let's cut this clip. So using the arrow keys. Find the last frame. So we want to cut, so you press C, and that'll bring up the razor tool, and we click.
Ronnie, what's going on? Talk to me.
I'm not meant to be here.
What do you mean?
Skip out. Summer.
Okay, and then we're going to use the arrow keys and we're going to scrub. Okay, and then we're going to cut. Okay, and then to change the icon, we press V again, and we click, and then we delete. Click the negative space, and we delete. So then there's our edit.
Please, come on.
Summer!
Look, I'll help you, all right? Ronnie, I'll help you. I'll help
Fuck you. Off, Daddy!
Okay, and then we're going to drag that over. And then I think there's a couple of shots, a couple of the next shots, which are quite good. So, okay. So again, just using spacebar to play and stop. So I think we'll take this shot. So this is our in point, I for in. Let's play. And let's say, our out point there. And we hit full stop. Period to bring this into your timeline. So that's in, right click, set to frame size. And that's probably enough of that for now. So let's just have a little look at that.
Oh my God, you're gonna love it. Beach all day, karaoke all night. No, I used to shave my legs, put a skirt on, and I would run the rings around this time. Up, 10 now. Double figures.
Have you seen a little girl about this big, brown hair?
Bonnie, she'll be around.
Summer!
Bonnie, talk to me. Please, come on.
Summer!
Look, I'll help you, alright? Bonnie, I'll help you! I'll help
Fuck you! Fuck off, Daddy!
Okay. So, I just noticed now, basically, going from this clip to this clip, and I should have explained this, but basically, so this layer is the video, the top layer, and the one underneath is the audio. So if I just hover there, I can drag this down, and it's going to show me the waveform. And then if we zoom in some more, you'll be able to see. This is the sound. So if I press play,
Ronnie,
you follow the timeline.
I'll help you.
I'll help Fuck you. Off, Daddy!
And then just here, you can actually hear the cut because of the audio. So how to fix something like that? We then go back up to this part and we click on effects control. Down here, we click on effects. And we want audio transitions, constant power, and we click and drag and hold that on the cut. So that's going to basically fade one audio file into the next. And if we click there, it shows you what it's doing. So if we just have a listen to that, you won't be able to hear the cut. Okay, cool. So that's enough of that one. So what we're going to do now is just give you an example of some other. Okay. So we've already cut some more scenes together. Obviously, it's going to take too long for you guys to sit through the whole editing process. But here, I thought we could give you an example of how to cut a scene that maybe you're not really the focus of the scene. So this is another film. This is another film that our actor has worked on. And I'll just play the clip that we've selected. So I'll just play this through.
Hi, sorry if you're accusing me. I have your application here.
Great.
Unfortunately, it's an unsuccessful one this time. Sorry.
Is that it?
No, there's really not a lot we can do.
Can I speak to the manager, please?
Sure.
No, please.
I am the manager.
Can you tell me my options, please?
Sure. Private rental.
I can't afford that.
I'm sorry, I know it's frustrating. It's just that there really isn't much we can do. I understand your situation.
Are you? Your mother?
Okay, so it's a good scene, but this is too long for a showreel. And we feel like that the focus is on this character. Now, if you were watching this film, you'd be invested in her story, and that's absolutely fine. So there's nothing wrong with this scene at all. But for the purpose of this showreel, our job basically is to showcase this actor. So basically, first of all, again, the file is a lot smaller than our sequence. So my first job would basically be to right click and set to frame size. The second thing that you probably notice is this graphic in the bottom right hand corner. So what we don't want to do is distract our viewer in any way. And for me, that's a little bit distracting. So what I've done, and you can all do this, you can go on Google, and if you were to search for aspect ratio, transparent PNG, and basically that gives you the black bars that you would see in a movie or in a cinema, and it changes the aspect ratio. So basically, I'm now going to play this scene again after I've edited. And I've added the black bars to hide the graphic, and I've tried to condense this scene as much as I can.
Sorry if you're accusing me. I have your application here.
Great.
Unfortunately, it's an unsuccessful one this time. Sorry.
Is that it?
No, there's really not a lot we can do.
Can I speak to the manager, please?
Sure.
No, please.
I am the manager.
Can you tell me my options, please?
Sure. Private rental. I'm sorry, I know it's frustrating. It's just that there really isn't much we can do. I understand your situation.
Are you? Your mother?
Okay, cool. So that basically shows that scene without taking the focus away from our actor. So the next thing I'm going to talk about is graphics. So at the start of every few clips from a production, we would have some graphics. So using the credits for our first film, which is Canby Island, so here, and copy that, and same as what we did at the start, we're going to add some text. So selecting the text tool, clicking on the video, and then Command and V. So then press V. And we want to just move that text to where we're happy. So there's not actually a production company on this one, but you would normally show the title, the director, and the production company would be underneath. So I'm happy with that. And again, we would want to add a fade. So we're probably looking like 1 second.
Oh my God, you're going to love it. Beach.
Then the title.
Today, karaoke all night.
And again, probably around 3 seconds, and that's enough. But we also want to put a fade in and a fade out on this title. So we go to the effects panel, which should be here. Video transitions, cross dissolve, sorry, video transitions, cross dissolve, and we drag that at the start. And we click and drag and add that to the end. And let's just play that back.
Oh my God, you're going to love it. Beach all day, karaoke all night.
And I used to shave my legs, put a skirt on, and I would run rings around this place.
Cool. So then we've got our second clip. And again, dead space. And you hit delete, and that will bring it straight up.
Hi, sorry for accusing me. I have your application here.
Great.
Unfortunately, it's an unsuccessful this time. Sorry.
Okay, cool. So we've got these two. And then I'm just going to scrub through some other clips that we thought worked. So I'll just play these.
Wait, do you know what time it is?
I'm sorry, Maria. Just give me 5 minutes with the boy here, please.
Visiting times are over, Joe. You've got 5 minutes. You're lucky it's you.
Okay, that's nice and strong. Then we've got another clip.
Do you enjoy working at the club? Sometimes,
yes. Sometimes, no.
Why no?
Okay, and then we've also got some clips from a music video. So I'll just play these as well. Okay, so I think at this point, we would rather bring in Hannah to explain why she would order these clips in a certain way as a casting director. So Hannah, are you there? Hello, hello.
I'm here, hello. Hiya.
So I suppose, first of all, has anybody got any questions so far? Am I moving too quick?
So I've had a few questions come through. I'm going to run through them then, if that's okay. Nothing too much about the technical side. Obviously, guys, we know this is like a super technical tutorial, and that is why we are recording it. And I'm just trying to think of the best way to make sure that you guys get it. But I would just say either email me on the email address that I sent out to you all at the beginning. I'll send it all out again, my email address again. Or just check on our YouTube channel, because we will be posting it on there. So, So what did you want to ask me with the reel? Order?
So we've got these clips, and we've you know, we're happy with the selection of what scenes we're using. So now I'm going to bring those into the showreel that we made. And from what you've seen, basically, what order would you, you know, as a casting director, what order would you recommend seeing these clips?
So there's the first thing that I want to say about that is when you've got multiple credits, and like some of you guys might not have too many credits, especially screen credits yet, and I'll have a little chat with you at the end just about what the best thing to do in that circumstance is. But if you've got a few credits, say you've got 3 or 4 credits, I quite like them to be in an order. So like what Warren's shown you here, where he's got the credit title coming in at the beginning of the one credit, and then we've got clip, clip, clip from that credit, and then we move on to the next credit, rather than interspersing it. Because like I said earlier, if a casting director or an agent is clicking through your reel, if we're going back to the same performance and the same credit again, we're trying to find the next thing. So I quite like it to be in that order, but that is just a personal preference. In terms of the order that you actually put it in, if you are going to do it in that way, I think it's quite good to mix it up. Like Kristen here has got a really good range of roles, so we can see her on a very broad spectrum on where we might be able to place her, which is perfect. So we've got her in a very serious role as the nurse there. We've got her in a very different role for Canvey Island. They're all very different. If you have very similar performance, then I would try and break it up by adding the one that is the most different in the middle of those, just so that if I'm watching your first credit and then I roll on through to the next one, straight away I can see the difference in performance. So I would just try and order it so that it's a little bit different.
Okay, so based on that information, looking at the first two clips, would you be happy with those? So we've got this one, and then we've got this one. So they're very different. So it's a good start.
Yeah, amazing start. So I would be inclined to watch all of that Canvey, because there's not too, the scenes aren't too long. Like what you're saying about cutting dead space out is really, really important. It is brutal, it really is, but that is just the way that it goes, that we don't have enough time to watch everything all the way through from beginning to end. So if you can cut out the dead space, then, which is like, unless it's like a nice look at someone which is important to your character or show's performance, then obviously leave that in. But if we're going on to the other character, the other person in the scene, then try and cut that out as much as possible. But I would watch all of that, because the scenes are nice and short, and then we go on to the next credit, and the next credit's completely different. And again, the scenes are nice and short. So that's perfect.
Okay, so so now, based on what I've cut, I'm now gonna select what's called Snake Eyes, or is it Snake Eyes? Snake Pit, even. So I'm gonna drag that as our next clip.
Enjoy working at the club?
Sometimes.
Yes.
Sometimes, no.
Why no? Tick-tock.
Okay, cool. And then our next clip, again, is a different, it's very different from the last. So we'll just drag that over, or click this dead space and hit delete.
Wait, do you know what time it is?
I'm sorry, Maria. Just give me 5 minutes with the boy here, please.
Just in time, you're over, Joe. You've got 5 minutes. You're lucky it's you.
Okay, and then I would probably bring in the footage from the music video. Again, click the dead space and click delete.
Okay.
Okay. And then just to finish off, we wanted another clip from Canvey Island. And I'll just drag that over. Okay. So let's just play this. Okay, cool. So this is the showreel. It's 3 minutes long. I've talked about how to cut, and obviously you can watch this back and you can start and stop and almost follow what I'm doing. But basically what we would do is then end with your slate again. So if we go back to the beginning of the sequence and select, so drag and select those two. So you've got the headshot and then you've got the name, and you're gonna do Command and C. Then you're gonna move to the end of the sequence and put your timeline about there, and you're gonna do Command and V. So that's Command C is copy, Command V is paste. So we have a look here. We've got that. And we want that to appear on the last frame. So if we just move our timeline and then use the arrow keys to scrub through to find where you want your frame. Okay, and then that's our in point for our end slate. So drag and select, and then we're gonna move this over like this. Okay, so we just, we could probably put a fade on, that. So again, in this area, you want to go to effects, video transitions, cross dissolve, drag and hold, put that on the text, and then click cross dissolve, click and drag, and put that on the headshot. So let's just play that. Okay, I'm going to get rid of that cross dissolve. I don't think it's working. So. And that was starting a frame too soon, so let's move that over. Okay, cool. So that is it. So we're just going to play this through once. Now let's just drag this over so you can see it.
Oh my God, you're gonna love it. Beach all day, karaoke all night. And I used to shave my legs, put a skirt on, and I would run the rings around. Okay.
Oh, 10 now.
Double figures.
You seen a little girl about this big, brown hair?
Bonnie, she'll be around.
Summer? Summer!
Bonnie, talk to me. Please, come on.
Summer!
Look, I'll help you, all right? Ronnie, I'll help you! I'll help
Fuck off, Daddy!
Hi, sorry for kissing me. I have your application here.
Great.
Unfortunately, it's been unsuccessful all this time. Sorry.
Is that it?
No, there's really not a lot we can do.
Let's speak to the manager, please.
Sure.
No, please.
I am the manager.
Can you tell me my options, please?
Sure. Private rental. I'm sorry, I know it's frustrating. It's just that there really isn't much we can do. I understand your situation.
Are you? Your mother?
Do you enjoy working at the club?
Sometimes.
Yes.
Sometimes, no.
Why not?
Wait, do you know what time it is?
I'm sorry, Maria. Just give me 5 minutes with the boy, yeah, please?
Just in times are over, Joe. You've got 5 minutes. You're lucky it's you.
Okay, cool. So you've edited your showreel and you're happy with it and you're ready to start sharing it with the world. So basically the next job, Hannah, are you okay?
Yeah, carry on. I was just about to jump in, but you need to tell people how to export, don't you?
That's exactly what I'm going to do.
All right, carry on.
So before you can do that, obviously you need to export this and get this as a shareable file. So what we're going to do is we're happy with this. First of all, we're going to save our project. If we want to come back to it, if we want to add or change something. So next is file and export. Export media. And this then opens up our export settings box. So basically the best format to be exporting this is an MP4 file. This is basically like a universal file that will work on a mobile device, it'll work on a computer, it'll work when you upload it to YouTube or Vimeo or any other video websites. You will be able to also upload this to your Backstage profile. So basically, an MP4 is a codec. So an MP4 is the name of the file and the codec is H.264. So this is what we want. And then we want to just go to something like Vimeo 1080 Full HD. So we can click that, and then we're happy with these render settings. And then the other option that we want to click is use maximum render quality. So we do that. And then here, this tells us how big the file size is. So let's have a look. And then output name. So you call it your name and showreel. So if we click here, we can then choose where it's going to go. So you would click exports and save and then export. And now this is rendering out your showreel. It's quite a quick process. I'm just on a laptop, so you don't need a super powerful computer. You can do this on a laptop, no problem. And then this is going to take about a minute. And then Hannah, I don't know if you want to jump in whilst we're waiting for that to render.
Yeah, okay, I'll jump in with some questions. Okay, so with the aspect ratio, you've broken that up in the timeline. For continuity, could you keep it so that it goes over all of the clips so that you've got the same aspect ratio going throughout?
You can. I mean, you saw how I hid some of the graphics on one of those clips, and I used the PNG to kind of hide that, and I actually changed the aspect ratio. For me, you know, I quite like seeing the different aspect ratios. It's quite interesting to see what filmmaker was doing. But for continuity, there's no problem. You can just have it all one aspect ratio. So the aspect ratio of this video is 16:9. And if you've got a clip that is, I could show you if you want. I'll just reshare my screen.
And just when you're doing that, somebody else has asked if there's any other resources that you recommend for learning to cut footage together with Premiere Pro. So you're self-taught, aren't you?
I'm self-taught. So I would say the best thing to learn anything is just to get in and play with it. It is very intuitive. And as soon as you start clicking around and, you know, you can't break anything, that is the best way to learn. There's lots of resource out there for learning how to edit. And all you have to do is just go on YouTube and in the search bar, just how do I edit in Premiere Pro? And there's tons of info out there. So let's go back to the question on aspect ratio. So if we look at this clip, for instance, I quite like how, for me as an editor and as a director, I'm looking at this and I'm appreciating all of it, not just the performance of the actors. But if you wanted to just show the video and change the aspect ratio so everything is the same, you would select your clip, you would go to effects controls, and you would basically scale this up until you're happy with how it looks. So we'll just click and drag, and there we go, that aspect ratio is now 16:9. Does that make sense?
Yes it does. Okay. Wicked. So I've just got a couple of questions which are around content. So we're really lucky with the footage that we've got today that Kristen had even more credits and more footage than what we actually cut in this showreel. And as you can see, you know, you can only squeeze so much in 3 minutes, 2 minutes, however long your reel is going to be. But somebody asked how long should it be. At 3 minutes, 3.5 at most is really enough. How many clips? As many clips as you have that are a good representation of you as an actor. So you want to show your best work. So if you're not sure on it, take it out, as I said earlier. Thumbnails. So if you can play with your thumbnails to, somebody asked if you should be paying attention to your thumbnails for your showreel and for self-tapes. Self-tapes, I've never really even registered a thumbnail on a self-tape. Sometimes you have it as this late, which is nice, I guess, but it wouldn't influence it going either way for me. For self-tapes, you just want to make sure you're in a well-lit area, that we can see you properly, and that we can see your face. It doesn't need to be any fancy setup. A thumbnail for your showreel, if you can, it'd be really nice to have your slate as the thumbnail.
So, no, it's not. So, if you're uploading that to YouTube or any other video site like Vimeo, you've actually got the option to choose what frame you want to show as your thumbnail. So if you've done your slate, you can just choose that as your thumbnail.
Perfect. So there you go. If you don't have any credits at all and you want to get a show reel together, now this is just from my personal experience. I would rather see a profile or an application for something with something rather than nothing. So I'm much more likely to take a chance on somebody and bring them into the room for something where I can take a chance on someone if they've got a small reel or just even one clip of them filmed themselves as either a self-tape or a monologue rather than no reel whatsoever. I'm much more likely to bring you in if your performance is good on that than if you've just got headshots. So if you don't have any credits yet and you are at that stage in your career and you need to be put in the room before you can get the credits to make your show reel, then you, as long as the content is good and it's a good performance, then you can use a monologue or a self-tape if you're really, really stretched.
So I would also suggest that, you know, there's a lot of filmmakers, aspiring filmmakers out there that need actors for their short films. There's students, there's people that have come out of film school and they just want to shoot. So if you can find anything that's happening, any filmmakers that, you know, want to shoot, then just do it. Build your showreel.
Yeah. And also, I mean, well, Backstage is a really great resource for that because the scope of jobs that go on Backstage are everything from like major feature films which cast through us and massive commercials with huge buyouts, you know, all the way to student films and even, you know, before people are going to film school. So there's a broad range on there and people will take a chance when they're at that level as well. So I would just try and keep your profile updated as much as you can on there and apply for things on there. But yeah, I would just try anything that you can pull together, as long as performance is good, it's better than nothing, in my opinion. And then somebody just lastly asked if I had any tips around if you should have different reels based on the media. So should I intersperse my commercials with my screen, and should I have a separate one for stage versus screen and blah, blah, blah. Obviously we showed a music video in this show reel. That's because her performance is good. We see enough of her, and actually it quite worked within amongst all of her other clips that she had in there. It depends on how much experience you've got and how much footage you've got. I do see a lot that people will cut a commercials reel and then have a separate TV and film reel, and then maybe even have a separate stage reel. What doesn't really help, especially with stage, is poorly produced quality video of stage performance. Just, it's not worth putting it in. Even if your performance is amazing, it's distracting, and we can't see your performance anyway. So if you do have poorly shot stuff in your overall reel, which is stage, then I would just take that out and just leave it as screen stuff. Yeah. And that's all that we have for today. So I'm just going to give you a rundown of what else we've got coming for the rest of the day. So in a little while, we've got a very broad range of things happening on the slate with Backstage. So we've got a workout session with Steph VS. We've got a forum, Ask Me Anything, with Anna Sophia Robb of Hulu's Little Fires Everywhere. We've also got an audition technique with cast and associate Coco Clappinger, and some content creation with kids. And then later on, we've got an Instagram takeover from Homeland star Sam Trammell, which will be awesome. We've had some really great people on the Instagram, so definitely follow us on there. That's at BackstageCast. And was there anything else I needed to mention? Keep an eye on our YouTube channel, which is Backstage Casting, I believe. So keep an eye on that, and we're going to post this up just as soon as we possibly can. Big thank you to Warren for all of your work on this. You've been really amazing. And big thank you also to Chrissy, Kristen Makawam. You can see more of her work and follow her on Instagram, on Twitter, on @Kristen_Macas, which is M-A-C-C-A-S. She's awesome. And yeah, thank you. Stay well, everyone. And I'll see you soon.